In this video, I'm going to show you how to install Kali NetHunter on an Android phone. In this example, I've got a Pixel 8 Pro running Android 15, and I'm going to show you all the steps to get Kali Linux installed on this phone. In this video, I'm showing you how to install a rootless version of Kali NetHunter on an Android phone. This is the easiest way to get started with Kali NetHunter. If you're new to this, then this is a great way to get started, but does have some limitations. I've shown in previous videos, which I've linked below, how to do a rooted install of Kali NetHunter on an Android phone. So if you want more power, you have more experience, then have a look at those videos. Now, my team and I have created a PDF that can help you with this installation. We're going to be covering a bunch of things, including the issue that a lot of people have had with phantom processes killing the GUI after a short amount of time. So we're going to stop that from happening by making a change within the phone settings. I'm going to keep this video very short, try and get you up and running with Kali NetHunter as quickly as possible. If you struggle with some of the steps, please download the PDF, which once again, I've linked below, that gives you all of the steps in a lot of detail. But hopefully this video will be very clear and show you step by step how to get it up and running on an Android phone. So on this phone, I'll swipe up and go to settings. Scrolling down, about phone, notice the phone is running Android version 15. So first thing we need to do is open up a browser and we need to go to the Termux app, the URL. There are two places where you can get this. You can get this from the FDroid store or from GitHub. Now on the official Termux wiki and Termux GitHub pages, they tell us not to use the outdated version of Termux hosted on the Google Play Store. So you need to download the software either from the FDroid store or from GitHub. Now, as always, you need to make a decision for yourself whether you want to install the software. It's at your own risk. You need to decide whether you want to run Kali NetHunter on your phone and whether you are comfortable installing software from GitHub or from the FDroid store rather than the official Play Store. That is your decision to make. So what I'm going to do here is select the first option to download the file. This is version 0.119, a beta, but I'm happy with doing that. So that's now downloaded. And I'm going to go to my downloads and I'm going to open that file. Now, we warned for security that this file can't be opened. So I'm going to go to settings. I'm going to allow the application and click install. And Termux is now being installed. Now, you can see the app has been blocked because it's unsafe. We need to go to more details and install anyway. And then we need to put in our PIN to install the application. We're told that the app is now installed. Now, again, you need to make a decision for yourself whether you're comfortable doing this. If you're not sure, then don't install the software. I'm happy doing that on this phone. So I've installed it and I'm going to click open to run Termux. I'm going to allow notifications. Okay, so Termux has now been installed. What we need to do is update our packages. So the command is pkg update dash y or hyphen y if you prefer, and I'll press enter. Okay, the next command is Termux setup storage. So I've got that typed here and I'll press enter. Now we asked, do we want to allow access? I'm going to say yes. Just be aware that you need to do this to give Termux storage access permissions, but it doesn't give access to external connected storage devices. So I've done that now and go back. Next thing we need to do is install wget. So pkg install wget. I'm going to say yes to install it. Okay, so that's now been installed. Okay, so now we need to install NetHunter. So we need to use the command wget dash uppercase O install NetHunter Termux and this URL https://OFFS.EC as in offsec /2MCEZ or Z if you prefer WR. So make sure that you enter the correct URL as shown on screen. I've done that here. So I'm going to press enter and the software is now being downloaded. The next thing we need to do is change the permissions so that the file can be executed. So we're going to use the command change mod plus X install NetHunter Termux. So I've done that here. So I'll press enter. And now we need to use the install NetHunter Termux command to execute the downloaded file. So I've done that here once again. I'll press enter. And as you can see, a Kali menu is displayed. We're going to choose one in this case to install NetHunter AMD64 and the full version of it. So I'm going to select one and press enter. So our file is downloaded now and will hopefully be installed. Some people have had an issue where they have to run the command twice. So install NetHunter Termux twice to actually get it to install. So either do it once or twice if required to get the software downloaded as well as installed. As you can see now, the software is busy downloading. I'll speed up the video at this point so that you don't have to wait for it to download. But in your case, depending on your internet speed, it may take a while to download. Okay, so as you can see, it's now downloaded. So what I'm going to do is press the up button and run the command again. So once again, install NetHunter Termux, and I'm going to select number one and press enter to start the installation. Okay, if you're told existing image file found, delete and download a new image, we're going to say no here. So I'm going to say N and press enter. Now, this is where the installation is going to take a while. If you get asked to delete rootfs, say no and press enter. So basically, you need to wait now for the installation to take place. If asked again to delete rootf, say no. Okay, so I'm going to say no to delete rootfs and press enter. And there you go. Kali NetHunter is installed now. We can run it by using the command NetHunter. So to start the CLI, we could use NetHunter, or we could just use NH as a shorthand. And notice we're now in Kali NetHunter. I could also use the command exit to go back. So to start the CLI, use the command NetHunter. To set up the NetHunter KEX password, use the command NetHunter KEX password. To start NetHunter KEX, use the command NetHunter KEX. To stop it, you can use NetHunter KEX stop. To run NetHunter's root, use the command NetHunter-R. And once again, you can replace NetHunter with NH for these commands, so shorthand of the command. Okay, but what we want to do now is make sure that we don't have problems. So I'm going to go to settings on the phone. I'm going to scroll down and go to about phone, scroll down, go to build number and press that 7 times. Have to put in my PIN. I'm going to go back, go to system, scroll all the way down, go to developer options, scroll down and select this option, disable child process restrictions. So I'm going to enable that. So this will stop the Kali GUI from being torn down, which is a problem that a lot of people have experienced. So I'll go back to NetHunter, and now we're going to use the command NetHunter KEX to start our GUI. So NetHunter KEX, press enter. We have to put in a password, so put in a password, press enter, verify the password. I'm not going to enter view-only password, so I'll say no there. We're told that a view-only password isn't used. And notice a port is now shown, and this is really important. Port number is 5901. So make sure that you make a note of this port number because we're going to use that later. Okay, the next step is in your browser to go to https://store.nethunter.com/packages/com.offsec/nethunter-store. So that's what I've done here. So I'm going to scroll down and download the store app, and I'm going to select open. Now, you may get a pop-up saying that the file might be harmful. Do you really want to download it? And in this case, you need to, so download anyway. As always, you need to decide if you want to install the software or not. Next step is to open it with package installer, and I'm going to select always, and then I'm going to select install to install the NetHunter store, and select open to open it up. We're told that this was built with an older store. That's okay, so I'm going to select okay, and then I'm going to select NetHunter KEX. I'm going to allow notifications, and I'm going to install the software. Software is now being downloaded. Okay, so for security reasons, you have to go to settings. You've got to allow this app and then install it. Go back and then select open. Click on this little plus, and now you need to put in the details. So remember, this is the port number that we saw previously. So if I go back, the port number here was 5901. So make sure that you change your port number to the correct port number, and then put in your password. So I've done that here. I'm going to press OK, and I'm going to save this entry. And now I can select that. And as you can see there, I've got Kali NetHunter installed on this phone. I'll twist it round. I'll select the little option here to rotate it. And there you go. I've got Kali NetHunter installed on this Pixel 8 Pro running Android 15. Now, if you need more information, you can go to the NetHunter website, the Kali website, as well as GitHub. So the Termux GitHub page is where they talk about this Termux issue on Android 12 and higher. So again, in this example, I've got two phones running Android 15. This is a Pixel 7 Pro. This is a Pixel 8 Pro. Both have Kali NetHunter installed. And the problem with child processes being killed doesn't apply because we fixed that. I see people sometimes complain about this. So on the phone, you can press those three dots there and that will allow you to disconnect. So on this phone, as an example, do the same thing. Press the three dots, disconnect. I can now disconnect and then I can connect once again to NetHunter Kex to log back into the phone. You can get your keyboard up by pressing the keyboard button. If the screen breaks like it's doing here, just disconnect and then connect once again, and then your screen should be working. Now, if you're interested in a rooted install or Kali NetHunter Pro, have a look at my videos below. I'm David Bumble, and I want to wish you all the very best.